Welcome guys. In this session we are going to learn about a query record processor. So that processor provides the ability to write SQL queries. So you can simply write select followed by the column name from FlowFile. So what this does is it provides the SQL developers flexibility to use SQL queries rather than being able to using NiFi processor and performing the operations. So from an SQL developer perspective, this is very useful processor, and with using this you should be able to speed up the development process. So I have a CSV file which I'm going to use for this purpose, which is called environmental text account. And let me show you first five records from this file. So you see it has quite a good number of columns, and let's say we do not want all the columns, we only want selected columns to be processed. So in these kind of scenarios we can make use of a query record. If we don't want to use query record, in that case we need to use extract text processor. So extract text processor is like more like regex based, and you have to specify patterns and all. You cannot just query the data using on the column name. So that's about the introduction. So now I'm configuring getFile processor. In this getFile, I'm specifying the name of the directory from where to read the file, and also I'm specifying the file filter. I'm setting keep source file to true because we don't want our source data to be deleted since it is a development environment. And in production, you can set these values based on your use case. So now I'm going to use query record processor. Now let's configure this processor. If you notice, query record processor needs a record reader and record writer. So we need to give it a way to know about the schema. So again, in the record reader we are going to use CSV reader, and in record writer also we are going to use CSV writer. So in our previous lesson we have already discussed about using record reader and record writer. So in this one I am going to show you a different way of using them. So this time we are not going to define schema, rather than we are going to use reading the schema based on the fields which are available in the file. So if you remember, in previous lesson we have used update attribute, and then we went to then we went on to adding properties which is called input definition and output definition, and there we defined the value of input underscore schema and output underscore schema. So that was the way we have read CSV previously, because we wanted our schema to be centralized. So now let's say you do not you just want to test a use case and you do not want to do all those centralization and stuff. So in that case you can use CSV reader with reading schema based on the header specified in the file. So that's what we are going to do. But just to show you what we have done previously is more like we have just went into adding CSV reader, and then we have went in onto creating new controller, and then there we have defined all the schema and stuff. So this time it is going to be different. So what I will do is I will before adding anything here, I'm going to delete update attribute, because in this scenario we do not need update attribute. I'm not able to delete because it is connected to the queue, so I'm going to delete the queue first, and then only we'll be able to delete this processor. Now I'm connecting getFile directly to query record processor. In the query record processor, in the CSV reader. Now I'm going to make further configuration. And in this configuration, if you notice, in the schema access strategy, I'm going to define use string fields from header. Previously, we had used use string name strategy. So this time it is going to be different. So that's it. I do not want to specify anything else here, because just based on the file name and based on the headers available in the file names, it is going to define the schema and it is going to read the file. So in this scenario, all the columns which are available in this file are going to be treated as a strings. So the use of defining schema is that you can define your actual data types. In this case, everything is going to be treated just as a string. So we have configured CSV reader. Now we are going to configure CSV writer, because query record has to read the data and as well as it has to pass the data to the next processor. So while passing the data to next processor, we need to specify what is the format we want to use to write the data. So I'm going to use CSV writer. And here you will notice I will select So here I have selected inherit record schema, which is actually default one. So what it does is it is going to inherit whatever schema was available in the previous processor. So whatever schema was available, it is going to use the same schema and not going to make any changes. So that's the same thing which we want in our use case. Let's enable this controller as well. So now, as of now, you see there is no SQL query which we have added. So what we need to do is we need to add a new property which is going to have a name. It can be any name, and the same name is going to get added in the relationship as well. So I'll probably give it a name of year, and let's say we want to see only year column in this case. Okay, so the query is going to be SQL-like query, which is select year from FlowFile. So for now, other than that, I have not made any other changes. So now you see year has been added into the relationship. Now we can route this relationship to any other endpoint. So let's add one more processor, which is called log message. So we are not going to write anything here. This is more like just a placeholder so that we can see the data in the queue. And for the year relationship, I'm going to connect this query record processor to log message processor. For failure and original relationship, I'm going to select auto terminate. Now let's create one more query in which we would like to select industry description and units. So we'll create one more relationship. So for that we are going to add a new property. And let's name this property industry info. So in the industry info, I'm going to add industry description as well as units. So you see how easy it is to write a SQL query. Okay, so this query record is still showing some warning. And before that, let's add this newly created relationship to the log message. So industrial info is going to have industry description and units, both the columns. And year queue is going to have only year column. If you notice, our query record is still giving some warning messages. So let's see that warning message and let's try to understand what is the issue. Okay, so I think it is giving error because we have used year column name, and year seems to be one of the system reserve words. So what we can do in that case is we are going to use year column in the quotes. So let me organize it a little better so you can see the warning message properly. So as you can see, this is the complete message, and this you can notice at the bottom we are getting error related to year. So year seems to be, we need to seems to be quoting the year because year is a reserve word. So let's go to properties and put year in double quotes. Now our warning should be gone. As you can see, warning has gone. Now this processor is good to start. Okay, I'm getting some error in get file, and the error seems to be related with some permission. Let me check what is the permission I have on the file. Okay, so we are reading environmental text account file from /tmp directory. Let me check on the permission part. So if we do ls-lrt, we should be able to see the permission. So permission seems to be okay. The file is having read permission for everyone. So I'm not really sure what is wrong in this case. So other than this, I have another file in this directory. So probably we may try to read the other file and see if that one works. Yeah, this one is still giving the error, so I'm not sure if what is the error in this case. I'm just checking if I have added any extra character here which is resulting in producing some error. That doesn't seem to be the case, and all the other properties also seems to be okay. However, when we start the processor, we still seems to be getting the error which is related to the permission. So let me see if we are able to read this new file, which is a big file comparatively, and this has many records. It has almost like thousands of records. However, the schema of this file is same like the previous file. Okay, so it still seems to be getting the error. Let me check the space. So space seems to be okay, we do not have any issue with the space. So we have enough space to process. So I was thinking maybe in the temp directory space is full and it is not able to create new files, and that's why it is giving some permission issues. But that's not the case. So let me change the permission of this file. I'm not sure if changing the permission is really going to make any difference, because this file already seems to having read permission for everyone. Anyways, let me change it to 777 in this case, so we can focus on the example. And also I'm going to change the ownership of this file to NiFi admin user, because that is the user with which our NiFi instance is running. Okay, so it still seems to be getting the error. Oh, I see. So guys, if you notice, the error which we are getting, that is related to /tmp/systemd-private some directory. So I think that is the temporary directory which is used by NiFi to place the files temporarily. And I think that directory doesn't seem to have the permission. I don't know what went wrong with that directory. So we can see this is the directory which is giving permission issues. Okay, so I think once I change the permission for this directory, this should be okay. Or rather, I have removed this temporary directory, because all the temporary directory gets created automatically again whenever NiFi performs the execution. Okay, so now the previous error has gone, but we seem to be having another error. So I don't really know what is going on, but it seems to be that /tmp is having permission issues. So what I will do is I will assign 777 permission to /tmp directory, because inside the tmp directory we seem to have a lot of issues. So I've changed the permission to 777, and now if we stop and start the process, the error should be gone. Okay, as we can see now, we are able to successfully read the file. However, if you notice in the success queue, we really have very huge file, which is around 204 MB. And I'm not really sure how much time it is going to take to process this file, and whether we'll be able to see the content of this file in the list queue, because this is really huge data and my system is not capable enough to handle this much of data. This is just a small instance which we have created. However, let me try clicking on list queue and seeing the view content, and let's see if it works. As you can see, there is already slowness, and this is the expected behavior which I was thinking of. So guys, whenever we click on view content, all the data has to be pulled over the network and it has to be shown here on the browser. So what happens is, let's say when we are trying to see a flow file of few MBs or probably GBs, we probably will never be able to see that file here on the browser, because that's really a huge volume of data and we should not try to see that file. However, in my case it is a few MBs, and if you have a good system with good amount of RAM, then you should be able to see the content. So probably I will try with some other flow file, and if that doesn't open as well, so probably we'll change the file, that big file again, to the smaller file, because the big file really having so many of records, and I'm not sure this is going to work in this case. And I will not be able to really show you the content. Yeah, if we try to click on list view, now the system itself has gone on a hang mode. Okay, let me try to view the content again. Okay, so in this case also we are not able to view the content. So I think we will not be able to view the content, and I have to make changes in the get file. And because if you remember, when we were getting the error in the beginning, we changed the file to big file, and big file is really having huge number of records. If you see industry info, that is even larger. So I will just clear these queues. So I'm emptying all the queues. And now we are going to change the name of the file. So the only difference between older and this file is that the older file did not have .bigfile extension. So I'm going to remove that .bigfile extension. And this file is a small file which is having very less number of records, and that is very good for our example in this case. So now let's run this processor. And we can see few flow files have already came to industry info and year queue. Now let's see the content in the queues. And if you see in the year queue, now we have only one column which is having data of all the years. And in the industry info, we should be having two columns. One is industry description, the other one is units. Okay, as you can see, we have both the columns, but in the data we have only data available in units, and industry description seems to be null, and that's why you only see data beginning with comma. As you can see in the original flow file also, I'm going to show you the original file. First let's see another flow file. So yeah, in all the flow files, industry description is null. So let's see this file on the server and see what is the content in the industry info. Okay, so as you can see, industry description is our third column. As you can see here, all the third columns are null for all the records. We do not have any data. So probably I will select another column which is called magnitude, and I will modify the query to select magnitude and units. And also you notice in our original file we have units column first and then we have magnitude. However, in the query I am going to specify magnitude column first, just to demonstrate you that whatever the order in the original flow file doesn't matter. When you are writing the query, you can select any query, any column in the beginning, or you can, so basically you can interchange the position of the columns. Let me empty the queue and then we will run the get file again. Okay, so after starting query record, we have few flow files in industry info. Let's read the content. Okay, so this time when we go into the view content, we can see we already have magnitude and units column, and we have data for both the columns. So that's how you can write your SQL queries using query record and process the data and make development faster. And remember, you can add any number of queries here, and you can add any number of relationship. So that's it in this session. See you in the next session.